Hey, hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu Let's Play The Stanley Parable. Ich habe jetzt übrigens nochmal nachgeforscht, was letzte Folge passiert ist sozusagen. Ich hatte ja diesen Punkt erreicht, dass...
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he'll simply
musst du mir mal reinquatschen. Also ich hatte ja den Punkt erreicht, dass ich das Telefon rausgesteckt hatte und danach war ich eine echte Person und sollte in die und die Richtung weitergehen und ich habe es nicht gemacht und dann ist mir das Spiel abgestürzt. Also es hätte eigentlich funktionieren sollen, dass ich einfach nochmal nach rechts gehe. Da hätte das eigentlich nicht passieren dürfen, habe ich jetzt rausgefunden. Trotzdem möchte ich das jetzt nicht direkt nochmal ausprobieren.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors. He entered the door on his left.
Nein.
This was not the correct way to
Aber ich möchte mal
and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Ausprobieren, was passiert.
By the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Wenn ich springe und jetzt hör auf mir
reinzuquatschen. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Vielleicht sterbe ich aber auch einfach, ich weiß es nicht.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Okay, vielleicht springe ich aber auch besser auf so ein Auto, ne?
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in but in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Ja, das denke ich auch. Ich hatte sehr viel Macht. Das will ich nochmal probieren. Ich weiß gar nicht warum. Ich muss einfach. Vielleicht merkt er das ja.
Und kommentiert das. To go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Wup, wup. Und los geht's. Wup, wup.
When Stanley came to a set of two open, this was not the correct way to the meeting room.
Ich bin viel zu schnell,
and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Stanley felt lightheaded, butterflies in his stomach, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Ja, ja, ich hatte Schmetterlinge im Bauch, ich habe schon gemerkt.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Boing. Wah.
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Schwund ist immer. Komm, also nimm's doch nicht so ernst. Also nochmal. Also
wait,
diesmal springe ich natürlich nicht.
This isn't the right office, is it? Is this Stanley's office?
Hä? Was sagst du? Was ist denn hier anders? Hat sich wirklich was geändert? Es hat sich doch gar nichts geändert, oder? Toll doch nicht. Hey! Jetzt habe ich schon wieder zwei. Warum kriege ich nie drei? Und warum sagt er nichts mehr?
When Stanley came to a set of two open, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Ja.
The lounge was grand, majestic. Perhaps, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing in your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself.
Now,
I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her. This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Mhm.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Bestimmt. Mal sehen, was passiert, wenn ich nichts tue. Okay, mal sehen, ob ich was an dem Ende dann ändern kann. Mal schauen. Ich möchte gerne nach links gehen.
Okay, there we go. All right now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your doom.
Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife who'd want to commit their life to you? I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Nein, ich will nicht. Ich will einfach nicht. Was?
But you're in my story now.
Aber ich will nicht. Lass mich durch. Ich weigere mich. Mann.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Ganz bestimmt nicht. Lass mich raus. Nee. Nee. Ich würde sie ja gerne ins Gesicht schlagen, aber es geht nicht.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
Ich möchte nicht tun, was du mir sagst.
Pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch.
Ja, ja.
Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work.
Starr mich nicht so an.
One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life. But in his mind, in his mind he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Mom.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth.
Suddenly.
The thought excited him terribly.
Mann, das sehe ich nicht ein.
So, he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last,
red schneller.
Choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold. As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
Ja, das wissen wir schon.
It was such a wonderful fantasy, and so in his head he relived it
again. Ich hasse es, wenn Dinge sich wiederholen.
Again and again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
Vielleicht.
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets. The more he forgets which life is the real one. And I'm trying to tell him this. That in this world, he can never be anything but an observer. That as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
Nein, mache ich jetzt auch nicht. Dum-di-dum-di-dum. Ach ja. Ich habe wirklich nicht vor, das zu tun. Ansonsten finde ich gerade ziemlich überflüssig, dass ich das Ende nochmal spiele. So war das Ganze nicht geplant. Naja, kann ja nicht immer alles gut laufen, ne?
You see, can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
Ich möchte Sachen in Frage stellen. Ich möchte meinen PC bedienen. Ich möchte meine Bleistifte anspitzen und schreiben und zeichnen und tun, was ich tun will.
I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled.
Das ist ein doofes Ende.
Perhaps. Well, maybe this time he'll see.
Ganz doof. Witzig nochmal.
And I tried again.
Bitte schön.
Stanley pushed a button.
And I tried again. But Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed the button. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed the button. Ja, wir haben es kapiert, denke ich. Trotzdem. Moment. Welches Telefon klingelt?
Hello. This is a recorded message scheduled either by you or a person in your place of work. The purpose of this message is to warn you about the dangers of recorded messages. If at any time you believe you are listening to a recorded message, please terminate it immediately and cease all flow of information from the recorded message into your perceptual sphere. Thank you and have a pleasant day.
Okay. Moment, gibt's in meinem Raum eine Sprachaufnahme? Wo ist die Melodie hin? Aber mein Licht blinkt. Das ist echt seltsam. Aber andererseits, nein, es blinkt nicht, es leuchtet. Die Geräte sind an, die leuchten, ne? Sehr kurios. Was stimmt hier nicht? Der Sprecher ist gar nicht da. Moment, was ist hier los? Was zur Hölle? Was ist diesmal anders? Was ist passiert?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ich glaube, ich habe was falsch gemacht.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to
admire
it.
Ich weiß.
And here it was, the lounge. But
was wollte ich hier nochmal tun?
To business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Ich weiß nicht mehr, was ich tun wollte.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door and got back on track.
Was wollte ich denn hier? Mist. Ich hab's vergessen.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Hey, wer hat umgeschaltet? Everyone is yearning. You most of all. Aww. Warum sehen die dann alle so gleich aus? Warum passiert eigentlich nichts, wenn ich in diesem Raum bleibe? Ich glaube, ich habe was falsch gemacht. Ich bin dafür, ich gehe hier wieder rein.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned
around
and got back on track.
Nope. Mach ich nicht.
There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow, just an empty broom closet. No reason to still be here.
Aber da ist ein Licht. Das ist doch bestimmt ein Grund, um da zu sein.
It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything.
Ich weiß.
At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way. As it is, he's literally just standing there doing sweet FA.
Ja. Choo, 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 choo.
Are you really still in the broom closet?
Yes.
Standing around doing nothing?
Ich spiele mit der Tür.
Please offer me some explanation here. I'm genuinely confused. You do realize there's no choice or anything in here, right? If I'd said Stanley walked past the broom closet, at least you would have had a reason for exploring it to find out. But it didn't even occur to me because literally this closet is of absolutely no significance to the story whatsoever.
Bist du dir da sicher?
Maybe to you this is somehow its own branching path. Maybe when you go talk about this with your friend, you'll say, "Oh, did you get the broom closet ending? The broom closet ending was my favorite." I hope your friends find this concerning.
Vielleicht sage ich das sogar zu ihnen.
Stanley was fat and ugly and really, really stupid. He probably only got the job because of a family connection. That's how stupid he is. That or with drug money. Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Genau. Ich stehe sowieso voll auf
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now. You're dead. You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here. When a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard.
Das ist zumindest eine nette Theorie.
In a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose.
Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead. He or she has fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities. It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place at the computer, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the history of narrative tropes in video gaming. so that the irony and insightful commentary of this game is not lost on them. All right. When you've done that, just step out into the hallway.
Wenn ich das nicht tue, dann passiert jetzt nichts mehr, wa? Ich glaube, diesmal passiert echt nichts mehr. Okay.
Ah, second player. It's good to have you on board. I guarantee you can't do any worse than the person who came before you. You too. Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to. A fish? Fungus? Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky. I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
Oh, Spielverderber. Gut.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Sieht alles aus wie immer. Oh, was ist das für eine Tür? Ich will rein, ich muss auf Klo. Mann! Dann halt nicht. Aber ich muss auf Klo. Okay, dann nicht. Hätte ja klappen können, ne? Ich hab's gefunden. Oh, wie cool.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life.
Warum geht das Klavier nicht?
Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him?
What dark secret?
What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him.
Boah, was für ein Schweinchen, lässt alle Gläser stehen.
Extra secret PIN number 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
Genau. Und deshalb kann ich es auch nicht eingeben. Warum konnte man gerade meine Maus sehen?
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
Haha.
2845.
Ja, schon klar. Ich möchte nicht. Oh, hallo Kamera. Ist ja wie bei Portal hier. Mir fällt nichts mehr ein.
But it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in and the door just opened all by itself. And Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Whoop-de-doo. Diddly-doo. Wiggy, wooby, timey, wimey, Alonze. Und weiter geht's. Rein theoretisch. Was passiert, wenn ich einfach wieder zurückgehe? Ärgert er sich dann? Ich muss nämlich immer noch auf Klo. Na, dann nicht. Was passiert? Hier und da. Bin in der letzten Ecke des Raums. Aber ich kann nichts finden. Schade. Oh Gott, habe ich mich gerade erschreckt. Ich weiß nicht weiter. Wie geht die Melodie weiter? Und welche ist das überhaupt? Entschuldigung, das ist Mario, oder?
Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him?
This question would not go unanswered for long. Warum kann ich nicht wieder hochfahren? Das wäre eigentlich voll nett.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Moment, nee, das habe ich ja schon mal getan. Hm. Andererseits habe ich das hier ja auch schon mal getan.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. Ooh. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Nope. Darf ich noch mal wieder zurückgehen? Nein. Na dann.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers.
Ja, ist okay. Lives of Lass so mich many einfach weitermachen.
Reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Hm. Also bin ich etwas genervt. Ich möchte nicht immer alles wiederholen.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Yeah.
No, he refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was
Never.
Unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Oh man, yeah.
But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded
Aber
from
es
this
ist
very
offline.
Place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over
never.
Another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Ja, ja, mache ich, bestimmt. Irgendwie, irgendwo, irgendwann. Oh. Wie, ich kann ja nicht drücken. Kann ja wohl nicht angehen. Zehn. Hübsche Melodie, nicht wahr? Es gab doch mal diese Knöpfe hier. Es waren dann 1, 2. War irgendwo hinter. Vier war, glaube ich, da oben. Vier. Ich kann nämlich immer noch nicht glauben, dass da nichts passiert, wenn ich das so mache. 1, 2. Moment, was ist das? Ach, schade. Hm. Ah ja, hier. 5. Was ist da unten? Ich verstehe das irgendwie nicht so ganz, wofür das gut ist. Fünf. Und hier auf den Schaltern irgendwie noch 6 oder so. 10. Für irgendwas muss doch diese Tür gut sein. Jetzt fängt auch noch das Spiel an zu ruckeln. Mich nervt auch, dass ich den nicht betätigen kann.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation. Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you?
Doch, genau das habe ich getan.
After they kept you enslaved all the years you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself, is that what you wanted?
Wartet mal kurz. Kann es sein, dass mein Spiel gerade ein bisschen abspackt? Ich glaube, das darf nicht so sein. Spiel, bitte stirb nicht.
Control.
Kleinen Moment mal eben. Ich bin gleich wieder da. Okay, da bin ich wieder. Mal sehen. Ich weiß nicht, wo dran es liegen könnte.
I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, Dan. There's only so much that machine can do.
Okay, warum wiederholst du dich? Ich kann nicht mal ordentlich spielen gerade.
You were supposed to let it go. Turn the controls off. And leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're gonna have to do much better than that.
Ich weiß. Ich wünschte, ich könnte mittendrin speichern.
I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent.
Okay, Leute, ich.
Stan suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex.
Okay.
How long until detonation then? Let's say 2 minutes. Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going. What all this means, I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are. A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die
Warum
anyway.
I'll
tell you
nichts.
Exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone.
Was?
Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though, this version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now?
Nein, ich finde den blauen Knopf nicht.
That timer, that something in this room was capable of turning it off. I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen.
Ah, ich sehe die drei drücken.
Every little thing in this room. These numbered
buttons. Die drei ist da.
Or maybe this big red button. Or this door.
Ich sehe keine. Warum eins? Das ist nicht lustig. Not funny. Spiel, das ist nicht lustig. Menno. Warum bist du so gemein zu mir? Und ich glaube, das wird eine ziemlich lange Folge gewesen sein, oder? Ich frage mich gerade, ob man das schaffen kann. Naja, vielleicht finden wir das bei der nächsten Folge heraus. Vielleicht auch nicht. Mal sehen. Bis demnächst. Ciao.